Do you ever see some weird hardware and you just think to yourself, okay, this looks kind of interesting, this looks kind of promising, but is this a genius idea or is this something that is just immensely stupid and is just not gonna work? Well, today we have one of those hardware pieces here. This is the SD Wi-Fi by FYSETC. It's a brand new, you've probably heard of before. If you've ever been on AliExpress, they make mostly Prusa clones, just straight up one-on-one clones. But this is something that is actually based on an open source project. It is, on the one side, an SD card, a PCB in the shape of an SD card. On the other side, it's a micro SD card slot, and basically this is just a micro SD to SD card adapter. But it's also got a little ESP8266 module on it that provides Wi-Fi to this thing. So what does that allow you to do? Well, basically, you plug it into any 3D printer with an SD card slot, or, you know, with an adapter into a micro SD card slot, and it works like a regular SD card. But at the same time, you can access the thing through your Wi-Fi, through your network, and you can read and write to that card while it's in the printer. So that's what we're gonna try out today. How well does that actually work? Is there gonna be glitches? Well, I've done some pre-testing. Yes, it's not a perfect solution, but is it actually worth trying the SD Wi-Fi over something like, you know, a regular OctoPrint setup that just runs on a cheap Raspberry Pi? We're gonna find out, we're gonna benchmark some things, and I'm gonna walk you through what this does, how to set it up, and, you know, how to work around some of the glitches that occur when using this. But first, I wanna address a comment by Stefan Kreuter. Tom, you need a haircut. And yes, I agree. Thing is, you know, when I realized, hey, I need a haircut a couple months ago, like a couple days later, everything closed down and, you know, hairdressers just weren't allowed to operate anymore. So there's really only one solution for that, which is to do it myself. So yeah, 2021, let's try some new things. Improvise, adapt, overcome, as they say, right? And you know who else lets you try out new things this year? Today's sponsor, Trade Coffee. Trade finds the best US-based roasters and matches their coffees to what you actually like. You complete the quiz on drinktrade.com and tell it how you like your coffee and how adventurous you feel. It matches you to coffees that fit your taste, and you can choose how often you want to get fresh coffee delivered to your doorstep. And then your feedback on the coffee you got gets factored into your next recommendations. Trade have switched their shipping materials to a compostable plastic, similar to the PLA we use for 3D printing. The coffee I got is Santa Isabel, grown in Guatemala and roasted by Irving Farm in the Hudson Valley in New York, which is a medium roast with hints of vanilla, butterscotch, and lemon zest. You don't have to be a nerd to have good coffee. This one is already ground for making good old filter coffee, the most basic form of brewing it. Just a paper filter, some boiling water, and that's it. Try out Trade through the link in the description below, and you'll get free shipping and 30% off your first bag of coffee when you sign up. Thanks again to Trade Coffee for sponsoring this video. So how does this actually work? Because typically, you know, an SD card is just a, you know, single sender, single receiver, basically one in, one out system. And if you now take the same host and the same, you know, receiver card and kind of try to intercept what's happening between there, that's gonna be a bit of a problem. Now, the thing is, SD cards have two different ways of working. The classic one that, for example, the camera I'm recording onto right now is using is SDIO. That's a specific SD card protocol that, you know, is high speed and high throughput, high everything. But what SD cards also support is, at least the older SDHC, is SPI, which is really just a microcontroller bus. And that's actually how most 3D printers access these SD cards. Now, what SPI actually is basically it's a landline connection and then a separate line that says, okay, I want to talk to you, or to you. So to that same landline, you can have as many devices as you want connected, and then you have a separate line that says, okay, I'm addressing you now. That's the CS chip select line. And what the SD Wi-Fi is making use of is basically the 3D printer is telling the SD card, hey, I'm talking to you now. And while the 3D printer is talking to the card, the ESP pauses. So basically, whenever the 3D printer is not accessing the card, the ESP takes over, and now that provides you the web service and the connectivity to the SD card. during the entire rest of the time, this is basically just an electrical adapter from SD card to micro SD. And again, if you don't have a full-size SD slot on your 3D printer, you can actually get one of these cool adapter ribbons that are basically a micro SD or trans flash size on one side and just an SD card slot on the other. So you can take this and adapt it back to a, nope. And you can take this and you can adapt it back into a micro SD size. So if you have something like an Ender 3 that just has micro SD, you can use this as well. Also, I don't see that FSY ETC is still making these too actively. And Big Tree Tech, the guys that make the SKR boards, are making some that are practically identical to these, and they also make them with a micro SD size. So how do you set this up? Now, there are two ways that FSY, I'm just going to call them Fizitech, okay? That Fizitech provide to set this up. Now, the first one is through an INI file you write to the SD card. That's one way that I just couldn't get to work. But this thing also has a USB plug, and there's a little switch that you can switch between card reader mode, the way that you use it in your 3D printer, and USB to Uart. So basically, you just take a USB cable, you plug this in, and it shows up as a little serial port. And with something like Prontiface, which is what I found actually works best for this, you can just connect to the ESP that's on this board. And then what you do is you give it just three M codes, so M50 and then the Wi-Fi name, so in my case that's EDMAX, and it echoes back with EDMAX OK. Then you give it M51 and then the Wi-Fi password, which is very secure password, and it echoes that back with OK, and then you do M52, and that's going to take a second, and basically at this point it's going to try to connect to that Wi-Fi. So there we go, we are blinking, which means it's connected, and we get a response access to SD at the run prompt with 192.168.178.39.dev.www.root. So basically, this thing runs a webdav server, and with a webdav server, you can do a bunch of really fun things. So for example, you can take this and you can go to your Windows Explorer, you can say add a network location, custom network location, yes, you enter your address, and this is going to be the SD Wi-Fi. Open when I click finish, and there we go, there's our content from this SD card now accessible over the network. And we can use this like any other drive. We can add files, we can remove files, rename stuff. So basically, like it's plugged into the computer directly. So the config is done. This is all safe now. I can unplug this and I can switch it back to card reader. And basically, we plug this into a 3D printer. This is still, showing up as an SD card in the printer. But we can now, while it's in the printer, also access the files that are on here. Now, that looked really easy and really straightforward, but it took me a bunch of tries to get to this point. Now, first of all, like I said, the INI config that you put onto the SD card, I could not get to work at all. Also, there is an issue with the firmware where spaces in the SSID or in the password are a problem, and also spaces in the file names on your SD card are a bit of a problem too. So I believe right now you can upload files that have spaces, but you can't modify or delete any. Then if you don't have the drivers installed for the cheap CH340 chip that's used as a USB to serial bridge on this part, you're gonna have to find the driver for that. And also baud rates to connect to this are really weird. So the bootloader that runs on the ESP actually needs 76,800, yeah? And then for the actual config to actually, write your config information in there, it's 115,200. So the standard baud rate that you'd also use for a 3D printer. But once you figure that out, it's, it's really straightforward. It's blinking right now, so it is connected and we can access the files on here. Yeah, and sometimes Windows messes up. So that's just something that I did run into. You sometimes have to restart the connection or you have to restart the SD Wi-Fi to get it to work again. So what I want to find out about the SD Wi-Fi right now are two things that are going to be pretty relevant in practice. So first of all, how does it perform against a regular OctoPrint setup? So this is a Raspberry Pi 2 Plus, the Raspberry Pi B2 Plus or whatever it's called. not the most recent version. It's connected through Ethernet to the same router that does Wi-Fi for the SD Wi-Fi. So how fast is it compared to the OctoPrint setup, and does it really make a difference to the point where it's not usable? And also, probably the obvious question is, what happens when we try to upload new files while the printer is active? So we're going to try that. We're going to slice a fresh file right here. I've prepared something. When we have this mounted or set up as a network map, we can just say export G-code. We go to this PC and we see it as network locations right here. And after a quick troubleshooting session, you can actually just save straight to the network drive, straight to the SD Wi-Fi. And that's going to take a second. You can see we're sending at 2.3 megabits per second. And there we go, exporting finished. That took quite a while. So average send was like 3 Mbit per second, and then it apparently read it back all the way at like 1.5-ish Mbit a second. And that is roughly what I also got during preliminary testing, that the testing that I did before I started recording this video. Which was about 1 Mbit a second, which means a, how does this work? So it's 0.125 megabytes per second, which means each megabyte of G-code is gonna take roughly 8 seconds to transfer. So typically the files that are on this SD card actually are like 8 megabytes, 2.5 megabytes. Let me see the one that we just wrote to it. So that's 8 megabytes. That does take a while to transfer onto the SD card and back. So let's try if we actually just export this file to the desktop, and let's see how long this takes to upload to OctoPrint. So we do locally, not to the SD card, and it's done. There we go. So that was maybe a bit over a second. So drastically different upload speeds to OctoPrint or to the SD Wi-Fi. Probably a factor of, I don't know, 50. There's also a file size limit on the SD Wi-Fi, I guess just due to limitations of what the ESP8266 can handle. And I've gotten errors with 60 megabyte files already, which is, I mean, a large, complex, detailed G-code is gonna be that size. Your typical small parts are all gonna be like under 20 megabytes. I don't know where that limit is exactly, but so far for small stuff, it seems to be fine. Okay, so we've just uploaded the file to the printer. So let's do print from SD. Does this actually refresh in the background? It might not actually, oh no, it does. There it is. So FS new, that's the one we just uploaded. Let's print it. I hope that was set to PLA. Yep, was set to PLA. So let's just get this printing and see if we can, well, if you can upload stuff to the printer while it's actually printing. Okay, so the printer started and the printer is reading from the SD card that's in the SD Wi-Fi, and it's working as expected, because this at this point is just a micro SD to SD adapter. So to answer the question, can you access or upload stuff to the SD card while the printer is working without interrupting the printer? No, like it's not interrupting the printer, but it's also not giving you access to the SD card at all. It's just giving you that file Marlin is reading from SD card. So, you know, closing thoughts, who is this for? What does this do versus an OctoPrint setup? So this is cheap. Like, you gotta keep that in mind. This is an, I think I paid like $8 for it, which already I would consider actually pretty expensive for an ESP module and the PCB, but you know, it's less than $10. Let's just leave it at that. Raspberry Pi, if you get the 3 or 4 or something, that's gonna be $30 or something. It's a bit more expensive, but not that much. Now, one thing I've not mentioned about the SD Wi-Fi yet is that it doesn't give you any sort of access control. There's no usernames, no passwords, no nothing. Anyone on the same network as the SD Wi-Fi can access everything on the card. Now, because you don't get all the real-time control features of OctoPrint with, you know, temperature monitoring and setting with actually controlling the printer remotely, starting and stopping prints, you don't get a webcam feed, you don't get any of that, so it's a lot lower stakes to actually put this on your network unsecured. But of course, it also means you don't get all of those features that actually make OctoPrint just a really comfortable and user-friendly and feature-rich setup to have. You know, to me, this is more of like an in-between solution when, you know, in my case, I have my main computer second floor, and the printers are in the basement, where you don't want to grab the SD card from the printer, run back up to your computer, put your G code on there, run back down to the printer. This is more like you do your slicing on a separate computer, you transfer the G code onto this, and then you just walk up to the printer, make sure it's ready, and start the print. For that, I can actually see this being pretty useful, actually. Now, the fact that this is still a fairly buggy experience with Windows cutting out on the web dev server integration, that kind of needs to be fixed. I feel like that is both a combination of just software that's running on this, as well as what I've read being the power supply on this SD Wi-Fi board being kind of weak, or actually the power supplied from the SD card slot being kind of weak. That might be something that can be addressed in a hardware revision, but so far this is, you know, kind of a buggy experience. Honestly, I wouldn't recommend anyone to actually buy this or prefer it or choose it over OctoPrint, because it's just such a limited experience. But even though this isn't working totally flawless yet, I still think the way that they're addressing the SD card is pretty interesting, where they've just taken that SPI bus and are just being a parasite on that bus between the printer and the SD card. I think that is a pretty cool solution, even though it has its drawbacks. So I hope you found this interesting as well. If you did, get subscribed. If you want to support the channel directly, you can do so through YouTube memberships and Patreon. I would like to thank Trade Coffee again for already supporting the channel. And yeah, thank you for watching. Keep on making, and I will see you in the next one. How do I walk off of this set now? That? Yeah.